Ladies and gentlemen, I said it. I said it would happen. The official Screwface Jean Patreon is live right now, right this second after you watch this video. Make sure you go join the Comedy Face tier, and right now you can watch my full Bill Burr Philly rant reaction uncensored and my Jim Jefferies Heaven or Hell uncensored right now. Ladies and gentlemen, guess who's back?
Hello.
Mrs. Face, Mr. Face, it's Comedy Face. We're in the building. You asked for Dave Chappelle's 3 a.m. in the ghetto, and we hear it. Dave Chappelle's a
goat. Too much pressure. That's my problem. I can't handle pressure. Sometimes pressure makes me talk different. I'm serious. You ever have like that social pressure? You ever talk to somebody who's fake, and they make you fake? Like, they come to you like, hey, how you doing? And you're like, fine, how are you? And you're like... I don't even talk like that. I get sick of that shit.
Man.
I do, it just makes me sick. Sometimes I'll talk crazy just to make myself feel better. You ever do that? Just start talking like crazy. Like, you ever hear this voice? Man. That's how bad guys used to talk in the 40s. In the old days. See, I talk like that. Not all the time, but if somebody put the pressure on me, fuck it, I gotta cut loose. Like, the police pull me over, I'll talk crazy.
Son, do you know why we pulled you over?
Nah, because I'm black, see? That's right. Nah.
Man, Dave Chappelle's the GOAT, man. Dave Chappelle's the GOAT, especially, like, at this time. I don't want to say he was in his prime because I feel like he's still getting, he's almost better. But there's something about this Dave Chappelle that was, like, I feel like our generation. That's why I always say Dave Chappelle's like our Richard Pryor. And the Chappelle Show. Did you watch the Chappelle Show?
I think I watched it with you.
You know the skits though, the Clayton Bigsby, the guy who's blind and black, but he's in the KKK and thinks.
I don't remember those.
The R. Kelly ones.
Oh yeah.
Come on now, legendary. Oh, by the way, make sure you guys comment, drop in the comment section the next video you guys want us to react to and thumbs up it. That really helps everything go smoother. And if you see one that you agree with, hit the thumbs up button too. Don't be a hater. You can comment it too, but make sure you thumbs up theirs. All
right,
okay.
That's right. I'll do it. It's not illegal to talk like that. How do they know I don't talk like that every day? Stop talking like that. Stop talking like white copper. Nah. That's how I talk, see? Nah. You gotta make life interesting like that, because the shit is flimsy. Life is flimsy. You think you're gonna live forever, you ain't not gonna live forever. It's dangerous out here. We know what's going on. I travel now, you know. Man, like, I used to think DC had the roughest ghettos in the country. Nah, nigga. Uh-uh. I have seen some shit now.
I'm sorry for pausing again, but even just the cane is just the, nah, nigga. Uh-uh. That is funny. Before he even gets to the joke, like, I don't know. It's just, it's like watching like a dope rapper. That's the same way I feel like when I watch Dave Chappelle.
Nah, nigga. Uh-uh. I have seen some shit now. Oh, there's some rough areas outside of D.C. Yeah, everybody should go to the ghetto. I was taken to the ghetto one time. That's the worst. When you get taken and you're not expecting to go. You know, usually you want to know when you're going to the ghetto, like, I'm going to see some wild shit. I got to prepare myself. I'm going to see something crazy. When you're taken, it's different. I had a limousine driver. It was after a show. It was late at night. It was like 3 a.m. Had a limousine driver. He was a nice guy talking to me and shit. Oh, hey, where you from, dog? D.C.? Word?
You sound like Snoop Dogg.
That's a rough city, man. And his cell phone started ringing. Hold on one second. Hello? Oh, what's up, nigga? What? What the fuck? Slow down. What? What the fuck? No! 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 Fuck that, nigga. Fuck it. I'm on my way.
You very much
hey, I gotta make a stop real quick. at 3 o'clock in the morning. And I didn't know he was taking me to the ghetto at first. I started looking out the window. I was like, what the fuck? It's gun store, liquor store, gun store. Where the fuck are you taking me? This don't look good. He didn't say shit. He just pulled up in front of an old rickety building that looked like a project. Now, I'd never been there before. I'm not sure if it was a project, but it certainly had all the familiar symptoms of a project. A fucking crackhead ran this way.
You know what's the craziest thing, too, is even in Nebraska, they have, like, not... Projects is just, like, government homes, right?
Yeah.
They have that in,
yeah,
in Nebraska.
A little income area.
Yeah, but, yeah, like, government-assisted homes, yeah, and stuff like, mm-hmm, that. So it's, like, literally, I can relate to this, and this is... But we didn't have crackheads. We had meth heads, so...
I think we have... There's both.
Yeah, there's a little bit of both. I ain't, yeah, gonna lie. There's a little bit of both. There's but a bit of both. The Midwest is, especially Nebraska, woo-wee. It's a whole different type of... It's about the same, actually, I think, because it's like both upper... I don't know, but anyway.
And then another one jumped out a tree and shit. And I said, I'll be right back. And left me. Took the keys with him and just left me. At 3 o'clock in the morning, in front of a project, in a fucking limousine. This was not good. I was like, man, I gotta look around and see if I can see some landmarks and figure out where I'm at. Might have to escape on foot. Now, this is when I knew I was in a bad neighborhood. You only see this in the worst neighborhoods. Remember, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. I look out the window. It was a fucking baby standing on a corner. <Look at this. laughs> And the baby didn't even look scared. He was just standing there.
See, what sounds far-fetched as hell, but in the village, you could, there'd be sometimes, because everybody's like a big family, you know, you might just see a baby just on the corner, just chilling, like, on the, up against the house, just somebody baby, just in a diaper. Nick, I used to do that when I was little in the village. Yeah. Like, so it sounds far-fetched, but...
That's how it is in Vietnam, too.
Nah.
Little kids can go everywhere. They can buy alcohol, buy cigarettes.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah.
We ain't doing that. You know what I mean?
No, they can.
That's crazy.
Yeah. There's no, like, age requirement limit.
That's not good.
No.
So everybody who's watching this, don't do that. But apparently, unless you're there, I guess. But I was just saying that because everybody's like a big family in the village.
Yeah.
So you'll see just your cousin running around just in a diaper or just chilling. Like, yeah. So I can relate to this.
I mean, it made me sad. It made me sad, really. You know what I mean? Because I wanted to help the baby.
Help the baby.
I'm like, I don't trust you either. I'm sorry. Click. The old baby on the corner trick, eh? I'm not gonna fall for that shit. Where's this limousine driver? You know, I start feeling bad. As time goes by, I start feeling worse. Like, man, what is wrong with me? What the hell is wrong? I'm scared of a baby. And this baby could be in trouble. He might need my help. I gotta do something.
Sure too.
But I wasn't gonna get out the car. I'm serious, man. I just cracked the window a little bit. It was an old limousine. I can roll it down. Hey, baby. Baby, go home, man. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. What the fuck are you doing up? The baby said, I'm selling weed, nigga. I said, oh.
Yo, the goat, man.
I'm sorry, I had to buy 2 bags from the call my name. Let me get two corners. Got back in the car and rolled.
Now, they wasn't
joint.
Doing that.
That shit was scary, man.
They wasn't doing that in the village. Let's... Ain't no dope trapping babies out there. That's the craziest thing I ever heard.
I was shocked too. I was like, wait, what?
I'm afraid to ask you about
what you're... I don't. I don't remember seeing that. Things are probably different now. I don't know.
Every once in a while, like a crowd would come up to the car and look in the window. It was like Jurassic Park, and should he be looking on the car? Hey, get out of here, Cracky. That baby was still standing there, man. Then I started feeling bad again. Yeah, weed make you feel guilty sometimes. You know. Man, what is wrong with me, man? I have just bought weed from an infant. I can't condone this kind of behavior. What am I thinking? I can't let the fear ruin my morals. Gotta do something. Hey, baby. Stop selling weed, all right? You got your whole life ahead of you. He said, fuck you, nigga. I got kids to feed. I said, God damn.
This keeps getting crazier.
Sam. And just at that very moment, one of the crackheads was running across the street and got hit by a car. I know it was a hit and run. The police did it. That's all right. They sprinkled some crack on him. He got back up.
Oh, my God. Hey, that was very enjoyable for me. I'm not going to lie. I love Dave Chappelle, period. So we are on the road to 30,000 subscribers, ain't we?
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, we're at 25,000 now. Make sure y'all hit the subscribe button so we can get to 30. You got anything to leave him with?
No.
Thank y'all for tuning in again. We'll be back.
We are.